What's up, Sushi Shun here today. Welcome back to another video. And today we are going to be playing a game called Whispering Dream. Now, this game right there is a psychological horror game about you playing as a unicorn boy character, I'm assuming that's what this character looks like, in a dream world where you discover some very interesting things, but also very creepy stuff as well. Now, I've never heard of this game before, but I have seen it before on itch.io, and it looks really nice. I like the art style and all. I wanted to try this for quite some time now, but I never really got around to actually do it. But today, I have the courage to finally try out Whispering Dream. And, without further ado, let us see what this game has to serve us for today. 3, 2, 1. Let's dream on. When you open your eyes, you cannot see a single thing. Not even as your eyes blink. Trying to adjust into a complete darkness. Where am I? It's so dark in here. I can't see anything. Hello? Is anyone here? Hello? Help! Anyone? Hello? Tap, tap. Huh? Is there someone there? You heard a faint sound of footsteps coming your way. Slowly, it becomes louder. Clearer as it draws closer, you feel as though someone is near you. Yet, you still cannot see a thing. You? Huh? The voice seems familiar. So familiar. And yet, in your hazy memories, your mind cannot place where you have heard this voice before. Why are you here? What? You feel the unknown individual stepping even closer. There is a tinge of concern from your voice, and you are not sure why. You are not supposed to be here. What do you mean? Where am I? What is this place? I don't think I could tell you that, at least for now. Then who are you? Do I know you? You sound awfully familiar. Never mind that. I'll take you back. Take me back? Take me back where? Oh, there's our character right there. Shh, calm down. Wake up now. Wake up. Wake up now? It's okay to wake up now. What? Oh. And we're here now. Oh my gosh, look at this. Ashley. Oh, that's the character right there. Ooh, interesting. Okay, I like the design right there. Huh? My head hurts. My bedroom. Move arrow keys in here, etc. Oh, okay then. Ooh, this game is looking really nice. It's like a dream world of some sorts. Huh. I'm getting attracted to this. It's so fluffy. It definitely is fluffy. A picture of my sister. She looks happy. Huh? There's no behind it. Don't be late. Don't be late for what? I need to find her. Oh, so we have a sister in this. That's something. Oh, and then we can see our reflection right there. My eyes look puffy. Oh, well, they're more like your eyes are extremely closed here. All right, well, I don't think I have anything else to go for, so we better get to it. It looks familiar somehow. Where there are always bunnies walking around. I should keep going. Oh, what the heck? Oh, I didn't mean to go this way. Okay, so we got a bunch of little bunnies right there. They're just hopping along. That's cute. Oh, huh? Another room. Smells sweet. Is that honey? Oh, a visitor. Come here. Oh, hello. Do I know you? Have you seen my sister? Or how do you know? Do you know how to get out of this place? Hello. I'm Lavender. You came at the right time. I just started heating up some honey milk. Do you want some? Sure. Great! While you wait, can you help me feed the rabbits in the forest you came from? I need to make sure the milk doesn't burn. Okay. They got 6 pieces of carrots. I will be waiting. Oh, why are we doing errands now? I mean, literally, we just came here. Like, don't we need answers as to why we're here? Okay, feed the rabbit. Okay, you feed the rabbit, it feels happy now. Okay, that's one. That's two. That's three. That's 4. And, that's 5. That's, 6. That's 7. And that's 8. What about this one? Okay. That's all of them? You've had all the rabbits. Wait, wasn't... But the carrot says it's 8. But why... But there's 9 rabbits. Okay, I fed all your rabbits. Am I good to go now? Can I try some honey milk? You're back! Thank you for feeding the rabbits for me. No problem. Confidently, the milk is done. Let's have some wild chatting, shall we? Aw, that looks cute. We're just basically, having some nice honey milk. That's cute. This is nice. Right? Honey milk is the best drink for snack time. May I ask you something, Lavender? Did you happen to meet a girl with pink hair passing by here? She's my sister. Ah, a girl with pink hair. I might have seen her. Oh, well, good thing that she didn't say, no, I haven't seen her, child. I'm so sorry, but she actually saw her. But where is she, though? I think she went ahead to that direction. I see. Thank you for your directions. I should be going now. Leaving already? Yeah. Alright, come back anytime again. Alright, come back anytime again. We should have some chit-chat again with some hot milk. Alright. See you later. Alright then, but before we do anything, let me just look around at some stuff here. It's full of tons of books. So, heading to this direction, she said. Alright, well, let's get to it. Wait, before I do anything, let me just save again, just in case something happens. And there's another character right there. Hello. Excuse me, but have you seen my sister around? Ugh, my head hurts. Oh, hey there, are you alright? Ugh, my head hurts. You poor thing. Maybe some fresh herbs will help you feel better. Oh. Here, take this and smell it. You should feel a bit better. Thank you. No problem. You sure know a lot about herbs, don't you? Of course, call me Sorrel. I tend the garden here. I see. Nice garden. Thank you. Well, if you're all better now, I should get back to my job. He looks busy. Maybe I should help him. Can I help you with anything? As a thanks for helping me just now? Well, if you don't mind, maybe you could help me tend the plants here? Sure, I don't mind. You got a watering can. Alright then, so I guess we just water the plants. Alright, just enough water. Just enough water. Oh, here, let me show you how. Too much water can kill the plants, you know? You need to make sure it's just right, not too much. I see. Good. I will go back now. Make sure to keep that in mind. Alright, you finish watering the plants. Water this rabbit? Wait, what? No, I don't want to water this rabbit. Why would you say that? Oh, hey, thank you for helping me. By the way, what are you doing here in this place? Now that I think about it, we rarely get any guests around here. Have you seen a girl with pink hair passing by here? She's my sister. Oh, she went to that direction, if I recall correctly. I see. Oh, see you later then, good luck. Okay then, just like that, I guess down here again? Another forest? Yeah, I guess another forest. Like, why are there so many forests here? Nothing interesting here. Okay then, well, this is the pink area. So, I wonder who's next. Hello? Have you seen my sister? I'm looking for my sister here. Excuse me. Hmm? Seems like he doesn't hear me. He doesn't hear you? Hi there, excuse me. Can't you see I'm busy? What is it? Don't bother me if it's not important. It's important. Not for me. Now leave me alone. I need to find my white book. Your white book? I should help him find his white book. Oh, his white book. Oh, so that's when we get the... Okay. You took the locusts in here and you're finding a campfire and you put them back. Let's check it out. Oh, yeah, so we have to find his white book in order to get his attention. Well, that can't be a problem now, can it? Seems a little bit rude. I mean, we already have everything under control here. Oh, I wonder where it could be. Maybe I could start with that pile of books over there. No, it's not here. Not here either. Is that it? Probably not. Should I take out these books? What if he gets mad at me? Maybe quietly? I'll put them back later. I should return this pile of books. You found the white book. Oh, okay, that's simple enough. Alright, here you go. Here's your white book right there. You managed to find the white book? Thanks. Here you go. Now, what do you want to ask? I am looking for my sister. Have you seen the lady with pink hair pass? She went to that direction. I will move the doll. You can go through. Thank you. He's already emerged with the book. Yeah, pretty much. He seems to like the book all too much here. Okay, well, at least he made us pass, so they can go. The trees. They're pink. How strange. And yet, I feel calmer. Oh, so I'm assuming we're getting close to finding our sister, maybe? So, is that her? Is that our sister right there? Sis? Oh, Delphia. That's her name, Delphia. Oh, she looks so cute. Like, she also has a unicorn horn as we do. That's hilarious. Ashley? Where have you been? I have been looking for you.
Oh my. I must have been wandering around by myself again. Thank you for finding me.
I want to ask you about the notes.
Oh, that note? No worries. We can talk about it later. You look really tired. You should go back and rest.
I'm okay, sis.
We have plenty of time to talk. I won't be going anywhere.
Alright. Oh, we just like that?
Let's go. I will walk back to you back with you to your room. I won't be going anywhere. I'm sorry. Good night.
What? What was that all about? Wake up.
Huh?
You need to wake up. Who are you? Huh? We seem to be back in our room. And something terrible might happen, probably. Who is that person talking to me in my sleep? Where is this? I don't know, but it seems to be something. Her picture disappeared. Oh, now something bad's happening. Oh, there's a crack on the mirror right there. There's a note under the chair. Take it. You have one piece of pink note. 2 weeks before the D-Day. Reminder. Book a nice table at Black Forest Cafe. ASAP. You keep the pink note in your pocket. Oh, wait. There's pink notes in this? Oh, we have, like, pink notes around here? What if it's around here? I can climb here, maybe. Wait. Wait, what's that up there? Hello? It's not moving. What the fudge? Is that a rabbit? What's wrong with it? It's not breathing. There's something under the dead bunny. Take it. It's a note. Shopping list. Blueberry cheesecake from the P2P pastry. She's the only one with a sleek tooth. Flowers, maybe? Hands, sparklers. A cute white notebook. You keep the pink pink note in your pocket. What the heck's all that about?
Hey there, welcome back!
Hi, Lavender. How are you doing? Do you mind if I look around and stuff here? Piece of paper between the books. Oh, another pink note. The heck? Invited some friends. I'm glad they said yes. Can't wait. Oh, so we basically have more collectibles here. The right ear is almost torn away. Oh, your sister went the other way. Oh, well, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. Okay, everything is already sturdy. Oh! Piece of pink note again. We need to come to the vein below before everyone to prepare for the X day. I hope that they won't be to be late. I should write a note to remind him. Oh, I'm assuming that's probably the sister talking, maybe. It has to be the sister, like, writing all these notes. Why would they call it the pink notes for a reason? Probably, I don't know. Hello. Hey there. Hi there. This one looks dead. It died overnight. Did I overwater it? I think you did. Ah! One piece of green note. Please, don't talk to me. I don't want to see your face again, ever. Please, leave me be. You keep the green note in your pocket. Oh, we're literally starting to get a little bit creepy around here. Alright, purple note. It's okay. It's not your fault. Don't blame yourself, alright? Oh, we basically have more colored notes around here. Now we have the librarian blocking the way. A note? It wasn't here before. You have a piece of a red note. Oh, now it's red. What are you doing here? You're wasting my time. You certainly wasted her time. Wait, waste who time? What are you talking about? Who the heck? Oh, it's you again. Hello. I'm busy. Please don't bother me right now. Can I help you with anything? Maybe you can. I am looking for my two books. I have been searching for them for hours, and I still can't find them. I see. Have you lent them to someone? Not that I think about it. Now that I think about it, you might be right. I remember now. The books were borrowed by me a long time ago by those two. I can get them for you. That would help me a lot. I still need to organize my books. Let me know once you have received them. Oh, so we have to go back over and get the books from the others here, I guess? Hey there, welcome back. Hi. Is there anything you need from me? Yes. Do you have a book from the librarian? Librarian? What do you mean, real? Yes. Sorry, but I don't know anything about any book. Something seems wrong. Yeah, something does seem wrong. Like, I mean, didn't the librarian said that the two have borrowed two books? Why did the one guy say he doesn't have any books right there? What, like, you came to visit again? Yeah. I'm doing an errand. Errand? What is it? For the librarian. Oh, do you mean Ryu? He does look like a librarian, huh? He told me to receive a book from you. He said that you have borrowed it for a long time, too. Lavender? I don't remember borrowing any book. Something isn't right here. I feel that I haven't borrowed anything. Can I try and look for it? Sure, go ahead. Yeah, I'll try. There's a lot of books. Well, what's the book that we're trying to find anyway? Is there anything around here? Oh, there's a book behind the portrait. Would you like to read the book? Yes, I will. Thank you. Once I had five little bunnies. They were all so cute and fluffy. But there was one I have loved the most. Of its white fur. I named it Ghost. I care for them. Day, night and day. Brought them to sleep under my sway. Till one day, Ghost did not wake up. Not a piece of carrot did she take. It broke my heart. But what could I do? Grab is time to bind a doe. What the fudge? Hello? What just happened? Did we just get some lore or something? Stop asking me about the book. I said I don't know anything. The librarian said you borrowed it from him. A long time ago. I did not. I know no book. He won't listen to me. What the fridge? I mean, I literally, like, who could have gotten the other one, huh? Can we still ask him again? Searle. Huh. Whoa, what the heck? I said there's no book for me to return! Leave me alone or I will... I will make you regret. 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 I will make you regret! I will make you regret. I will make you regret. I will make you regret for the rest of your life! What the fudge? He just turned on Suki there for a second. There's a book on where we're Sorrel. There's on the book where Sorrel was standing before. Would you like to read it? Sure, I guess. Once upon a time, there lived a young man who loved to grow and care for plants. Every day, he takes his watering can and tends to his nursery till the day ends. One day, he came upon a special seed, and how special to him it was. For it would grow into a flower he very much cherished. Alas, before it could bloom, it perished. Sad and heartbroken and forlorn, the young man looked to the sky with scorn. So basically, the two of them have lost something dearly, and I guess they turned sour, probably. Is that why? Oh, Hope, why did you lead me astray? If in the end, you'd only go away. I should bring this book back to him. Alright, well, we have done our stuff. That was a little bit creepy as to what happened. Now we get to give him the books. You're back! Did you get the books from him? Yeah, here. Indeed. These are the books I'm looking for. Thank you. Ryo? Is there something wrong with both Lavender and Sorrel? They started acting weird when I asked about the books. The books. They love them. That's the only thing you should know. Love? But it's yours. And what do you feel when something you love has been taken away from you? I don't understand. Do you have anything that you love? What I love? And that is not here anymore? I don't know. You know. You do know. My head throbs. I can't think clearly. And that is not here anymore. You have to remember. Whoa, what? What do you mean? I believe you're ready for the truth. Take this book. You received a white book from Ryu. Oh no. Are we going to learn the truth? What is... Oh. Go back. Go back? What the fudge? Wait, hold on. I need to save this for just a moment real quick. Save this just in case. Now the background's saying, go back, go back, go back, go back, go back. Hello? Oh god, look at the background now. It's all distorted. Several books are stirred here, but none catches my attention. Nothing important here. It's similar to what I had in my bedroom. Yeah, it definitely does. The money's not moving at all. Yeah, because it's dead. The flower seems dead. Oh my gosh, what the fudge? There's a note on the desk. Do you want to read it? Guess. What does it say? Today's the day. I'm so excited. Today's the day. I'm so excited. I hope everything will go as planned. Might need to check things one more before we begin with the preparations. You keep the pink note in your pocket. Ugh, my head hurts. You close your eyes for a few moments. Open your eyes. Run away. Run away from this place. You don't belong here. Huh? What? Whoa, what the heck? What happened to this room? Everything is dark. I can't see clearly. Oh no. Wait, what? Remember to save from the menu? What the fudge happened? What happened? There's a scribble on the chair. What the heck happened? Everything just now turned crazy now. What the fudge? There's a huge crack in the wall. What the fudge? Where did the head go? I'm gonna see some horrible things with a bunny. There's a bunny head. Peek inside the bunny head. Got one piece of a white note. It should have been me. Why am I the one still alive? I should have been dead. You keep the white note from your pocket. The world name is happening. What's this going on? As you step into the pool of blood, you find yourself sticking to it. Downward and downward. I can't move! No! This is how it's supposed to end! The deep red blood swallows you whole, dragging you into the unfathomable depths until there's nothing you could see but complete darkness. Sis, I'm sorry. What? Game over. Drowning in red. What? We just died by stepping inside the thing? We just died while stepping inside the red puddle. Well, we can't just step on that, so we might as well just go this way, I guess. So yeah, don't step on the red stuff here. What happened here? Hello? Ryu? Boo! Ryu! Are you okay? Ryu? Forget. I need to forget. He won't listen to me. My book. I need to forget everything. I need to find the book. Maybe he will talk if I bring him his book. They're looking for me. Okay, well, where is the book, really? You found the book with the title, Black Rose and the Seven Elves. Would you like to take this book to Ryu? Sure. Let's bring this to Ryu. Is it this one you're looking for? Ryu. My book. Is this your book? My book. Not my book. I'm sorry? Not my book! Ryu rushes toward it, rushes toward her, and took the book from your hand. He swung it to your head, snapping your neck, the life out of you. Bro, what? Game over end. Whoops, wrong book. Bro. Wow, he just bloody threw a book at me. Wow, that's not very nice. Oh my gosh, okay. Well, since that is not the book we were trying to get to. Okay, let me just save this for just a moment real quick. Alright, so is it this one? Hello, is it this book that you're seeking for? Of course, it's not your book. Freaking not your book, man. Come on, man. Hansel and Gretel. Alright, this is the last one. Joyce and the Giant Pumpkin. Maybe this one. What is your book, man? Where? There's something inside the doll. Take it. It's a note. A red note. What do you seek here? To torment me further? Everything that happened is your fault, and yours only. It should have been you. You will pay for this someday. All of it. You keep the red note in your pocket. The heck? There's small writing on the board. Birds of the feather must stay together, and on your own to die alone. What a strange poem. I wonder what it means. Probably something. Okay, I'm guessing the book is here. Oh! As you take a closer look at the bookcase, something snatches your hand as you are about to take a book. Ah! Let go! The bookcase goes further as you struggle to pull your hand away, not realizing that the bookcase is falling towards you. Oh my gosh. Game over too. Put your life on the shelf. Bro, what? Not this one. I think it has to be in order, maybe. The Lone Bird. I don't think I've seen that one before. Let's try. Ryu? Should I read it to him? Oh, okay, that is the right book. Okay, this The Lone Bird. Uh-oh. So we're now reading the book and say what it is. Thus, a fine, dreary morning, deep in the forest, the sun's rays softly touched upon the trees as it gently awakening them the new day. Birds to awaken and begin chirping a tune, a merry little melody as they fly away from their nests. A small red sparrow was all that remained in the nest, let alone by the others. He simply perked at the edge of the nest, forlorn the watching as the others flew together, wondering if he would ever be part of their group. He did not realize that one had remained, waiting for him to take flight too, a bird with purple feathers perking next to him. Soon, from there on, and so from then on, he flew with her. Slowly but surely, she brought him closer to the other birds, until he truly became part of the flock. I heard something is moving. I should continue reading. Oh, we're just... Okay, so... Something is moving, so we are... I think whatever we're doing, it's working. But on one dark and gloomy morning, before they took their morning flight, he could not find his purple-feathered friend. For days, he could not find her, even as he looked everywhere for her, until one evening, gloomy as the day she disappeared, he finally found her, lying motionless on a bed of rocks, never to return to life again. Oh no, foreshadowing, I'm assuming. What the heck? What is with all the death stuff is going on? What does that even mean? Is this symbolizing something? What the heck are you going to say now, huh? What was that? I better get going. Oh, that was it? Alright then. Whoa, what was that? Oh god, I did not even see that. Alright, save that just in case. What the fudge? Alright, run! Excuse me? Sorrel? Oh god, there's Sorrel. What's up? Sorrel? What happened to you? Where is it? You find it! Find it now! Or else! I will make you regret! Find what exactly? Find me the tulip blub. The tulip? What is it? Is it third? Oh, frick. Okay. We're finding the tulip. How do we do that? How do we find the tulip? Where's the tulip? I don't know where it is, man. Oh, frick. Oh, God. Oh, God. I can't even see. I can't see. Time is up. Where is it? I need it. It will make you regret. What? Sorrel the rushes in with a sharp blade displayed in hand and plunges it into your stomach. You feel a stirring pain overwhelming your sense, and you begin to lose consciousness as you keep losing blood. The last thing you see is Sorrel covered in your blood. What the fudge? Keep digging. What the fudge? Oh, there's a bub! I should hurry give it to Sorrel. Okay, the tulip bub. Hey, here! My blub. My precious tulip blub. It's back! But... she won't be back. Sorrel. It's because of you! You should have been the one! Not her! She is not coming back! I'm sorry. It's too late! You have made it all too late! You should end your life. Leave! Leave this place now! My head hurts, Bro, what's your deal, man? Right. Ah! As you reach and run away, the unicorn's jaws open, revealing a set of sharp, jagged teeth and a large, fleshy tongue. The tongue lunges out like a tendril, grabs you, and drags you into its gaping maw. Oh, God, no! No, stop! Unable to escape from the unicorn's strong grip, you soon melt into the darkness as the jaws closes. Game over. Where are you going? Bro, there's just... That's a lot of, like, game overs for one little game right there. I didn't even expect that. There we go. Finally. Lavender? Oh, God. She has a very creepy face out of everyone here. Lavender? Hello. Welcome back. You know, she's not here. I'm sad and lonely. Who? You know. I know you know. I miss her. I know. I know. You don't need to leave. You stay. Stay here with me. Stay with me. I'll make you stay. I'll catch you and you'll stay. I will make you stop walking so you won't be able to leave this place. No! Where are you going? Don't go! Don't leave me! Come back! She's coming, I need to run. Whoa, run. Ah! No! Let go! I caught you. I caught you! Lavender! You won't leave, right? No, I won't leave. I won't believe you. She said she will be with me forever. But she's gone. Long gone. You won't leave this place ever again. I'll make you stay. I will stay, Lavender. I promise I won't go anywhere. You won't go? Then you won't need your feet anymore. I know. We can have them. They haven't been fed. My bunnies. The bunnies opened their mouths to show sets of sharp teeth as they slowly sank them into your feet. You can feel your blood spilling. Oh God, they're taking away my feet! No, not my feet! Your scream only causes Lavender to laugh louder as you feel your vision getting darker. You can see her smiling. Game over. I promise to feed them. Oh God. Right, run. Just run. Just go. Don't look back. Wait, what even is that bat in the background? Hold on. What is this? Go! There's a white folded one on the floor. Would you wish to take it? At one page. Maybe I should just stay here. I shouldn't wake up. I'd serve the eternal torment. Oh gosh. Okay, come on. Go. Oh gosh. We made it! There she is, her sister. But let me just go and see there. Looks like your sister is sleeping soundly. You can see that she's still and silent and moving. Huh. Sis. You want to wake her sister? Yes, of course. She's my sister. We gotta wake her up. Wake up! You try to shake her, but she's not responding. Sis. I should find another place to hide. Sis! Wake up! There's something bad's gonna happen, man. You need to wake up, hon. I wasn't a couple before. We can hide in here. Hey! Where did you go? Where are you? She's coming. I have to hold the door from opening. Are you there? Where are you? You're not under the chair, are you? Like my bunnies. My dead bunnies? I hate it when they hide away from me! Come out, little bunny! No, I will not come out. Get away from me. Come out wherever you are! She's coming closer. Tap, tap, tap. Ah! You're here, aren't you? Yes, you are. I found you. Just like all my bunnies. All my dead bunnies. I always found them. My head hurts. The loud noises. Come out! Come play with me! I don't want to be here. I'm scared. I want to leave. Oh my God, her laughter though, it's very creepy. Huh? You don't recognize any of the voices. Help. Thanks. You feel like you're gaining your consciousness. You can faintly see one shadow leaving and one staying. You struggle to open your eyes. Ugh. The shadow looms closer to form a person. Who is that? You're awake! You blinked slowly and were able to see things clearly. You saw a face you didn't recognize. Oh. Oh, hello there! You a doctor? Who are you? You're finally awake. That's a relief, at least. Where am I? Did you not remember anything? How did I get here? Hello? It's okay. Everything will be okay now. I'm your something. I will take care of you.
Okay.
Us? Oh! What, we just got up in a hospital! And the curtain is basically blocking my face, why is it doing that? Okay, so that was us, so just playing Whispering Dream. I have to say, this is a pretty good game. And also a pretty big mystery too, because we started off so cutesy with a dream fest with meeting our sister in this and some friends over. And slowly turns into a distorted nightmare. And even left out some notes really, which I didn't really clearly understand. But I'm assuming that something happened in our real life scenario here. And probably something happened to our sister, and some of these imaginary friends are probably real-life people that we know. But, who knows, really. I only got the normal ending and all that, but, yeah, I quite enjoyed this game a lot. So, that's gonna be all for today, everybody. So, thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed today's video. Make sure you go subscribe to my channel, give all the likes, subscribes, or anything, or you're trying to see me. And hopefully, looking forward for new videos in the future. So, there we go now, and bye, guys! Yeah, bye!